It's recommended by the manufacturer to fully inspect every self-contained self-rescuer, or SCSR, 4 times a year. If you're a trainer, safety officer, or foreman, you may be responsible for making these 90-day inspections. Learn to do it right. Your crews are depending on you. The 90-day inspection is made up of 2 parts. One part of the job is to first repeat the visual inspection that workers make before every shift. The second part is to check an SCSR's reliability with the CSE Acoustic Solids Movement Detector, or ASMD. You'll also have to make sure the ASMD is accurately calibrated by using the CSE Spot Checker. This video will review the guidelines for visual inspection, the procedure for field testing the SCSR with the ASMD, and the operation of the Spot Checker. Here's what you'll need to perform the full 90-day inspection. Access to all SCSRs. The belt pouch for each SCSR. An ASMD. A supply of fresh 9-volt batteries. And a spot checker. An SCSR is a valuable asset, and taking one out of service is a serious step. So when is an SCSR okay for use? And when should you dispose of it or return it to CSE? The visual inspection is the first step in answering that question. For the 90-day inspection, you must visually inspect all SCSRs, both carried, meaning every unit that has been worn on a worker's belt, or carried or stored on mobile equipment, and cached, meaning units placed into service but kept in permanent stationary storage. If the SCSR is in a pouch, start by removing it. You'll need to see it on all sides. Make sure the pouch fits loosely, so the user can get to the SCSR fast when needed. Replace the pouch if it's damaged or unusable. You'll have an easier time spotting damage on a clean SCSR. If the unit has been carried on the job, wipe it down with a damp rag if needed. Make sure all 3 indicator windows are clear of grime, but never immerse an SCSR in water, and never pressure wash it or clean it with petroleum-based solvents. Here's what to look for on the Black Model SRLD. The top and bottom moisture indicators should be half blue and half white. If either one turns solid blue, the SRLD fails. Return it and get a replacement. The temperature indicator should be white. If the temperature indicator looks pink or light red, it still passes. However, if the temperature indicator is red, it fails. Return it and get a replacement. The indicators are important because moisture and heat will damage the components and chemicals that produce oxygen when your SCSR is operating. Now, check the date of manufacture. It's marked on the stainless steel security band and on the case next to the band. If it's been carried on the job and is more than 5 years old, take it out of service. If it's always been in permanent stationary storage and is more than 10 years old, take it out of service. Now, let's check for some signs of external damage. Here are some of the signs to watch for. An SCSR that's been opened accidentally can fail, even if the covers are still in place and the starter tag hasn't been touched. Loose or bent security bands, cracks or punctures, dented covers, loose, dislodged, or damaged rubber seals. All of these SCSRs must be taken out of service due to excessive physical damage. The next step in the visual inspection, you must inspect the pull loop and clip. Ordinarily, the loop is held flat by a small steel clip so it can't be pulled accidentally. But a hard physical impact to the clip may cause it to hold the loop tightly. You can inspect the loop and clip by moving the fabric back and forth. If the loop cannot move back and forth at all, adjust the clip to allow for slight movement. If the loop is torn or missing, return it and get a replacement. Finally, check the tamper seal, a small copper security seal that wraps around the steel security band on top of the SCSR. Make sure the seal is undamaged, as you see here. If the seal is broken or missing, return it and get a replacement. Once your visual inspection has identified the obviously damaged units, you'll need to perform the ASMD swing test on the others. For the 90-day inspection, you only ASMD test carried SCSRs, meaning units that have been worn on a worker's belt or carried or stored on mobile equipment, and any unit that's been out of permanent stationary storage. SCSRs that are cached, stationary storage do not need the ASMD test. That's because even a careful visual inspection can't always show if age, physical impact, or other factors have damaged the chemical bed inside the SCSR that supplies the user with oxygen. Understanding how an SCSR works will help you see why the test is so important. The key component is a bed of chemical granules that absorbs carbon dioxide and generates oxygen. Water, excessive temperature changes, and vibration can reduce the chemical bed's effectiveness, even though the unit may look okay from the outside. But with the ASMD, you can detect chemical bed deterioration that you can't see. As you swing test an SCSR, the ASMD analyzes the sound made by movement in the chemical granules and flashes a red failure light when it detects an abnormal sound level. At the start of every testing day, check the ASMD's calibration using the CSE spot checker. The calibration check is a simple procedure, but you should schedule enough time to do it carefully. The spot checker duplicates the abnormal sounds that the ASMD is designed to detect. If the spot checker sets off the ASMD's red failure light, you'll know that the ASMD sensitivity is set correctly. First, check the calibration date sticker. Your spot checker should have been calibrated no more than 6 months ago. If the calibration date sticker is missing or not current, don't use the spot checker. Contact your CSE representative or send the spot checker back to CSE for calibration. If the calibration sticker is current, power up the spot checker. Plug its power adapter into a 120-volt outlet. Connect the power adapter cable to the socket in the spot checker's base. Flip the power switch on the spot checker's base to on. The green power will glow and the spot checker will emit a high-pitched tone. If the power light does not glow, check the connections. If the spot checker still does not respond, don't use it. Contact your CSE representative and ask for repairs or a replacement. All set? Now, use the spot checker to test your ASMD's calibration. With the power switches of the ASMD and the spot checker on, join the two devices at the rubber cones, firmly enough to compress the foam layer of the ASMD cone. If the light on top of the ASMD glows red, it's calibrated and ready for use. If the light on top of the ASMD does not glow, replace the battery or contact your CSE representative to order a replacement ASMD. Now that you've confirmed that the ASMD is properly calibrated, you can use the ASMD to test your SCSRs. Make sure that the ASMD power switch is on. The power light should glow green. If the power light does not glow, replace the battery. You can find instructions for replacing the battery in the CSE SCSR manual. Okay, you're ready to attach the ASMD to the SCSR. First, remove the SCSR from its pouch and set it on a flat, dry surface. Slip the ASMD harness over the top of the SCSR. Pull it down snugly around the top cover and shell. Strap the ASMD firmly against the SCSR. Pull the straps tight enough to compress the foam layer of the ASMD's cone against the SCSR. Secure the straps with the Velcro tabs. Confirm that the ASMD is operating normally by tapping the top cover of the SCSR with your finger. The red failure light on top of the ASMD should flash with each tap. If the failure light does not flash when you tap the SCSR, try replacing the battery, then recheck by tapping on the SCSR again. If replacing the battery does not resolve the issue, contact your CSE representative to order a replacement ASMD. Now, you're ready to perform the ASMD swing test. Remove any rings or other jewelry that could rattle and produce a false reading. Lock your elbow against your body and swing the SCSR in a smooth, continuous rocking motion from shoulder level to waist level and back. Repeat the motion 4 times in about 4 seconds. Don't shake the SCSR abruptly or violently. Rough treatment will produce false readings. Watch for the flashing red failure light. No red light, the SCSR passes. Okay, return it to service. If the red light flashes once or twice during the first or second swing, the SCSR still passes. Return it to service. If the red light flashes or glows steadily throughout the test, the SCSR fails. Document each inspection according to company policy and any applicable regulations. Dispose of any SCSRs that fail inspection according to your company's policies. You'll find more information about using and maintaining the ASMD and the spot checker in the CSE SCSR manual. Remember that only trained individuals can approve SCSRs for service, and that only CSE can calibrate the spot checker if it needs attention. Testing is one of the most important assignments you'll ever have. These men were able to reach safety because their rescue breathing equipment worked when they needed it. This video is for supplemental training and reference and does not replace the need to review all product literature, which can be found at www.csecorporation.com. If you have any questions, you can contact CSE or your local representative.